Hello peeps, my name is Kevin Duty. Welcome to my channel and thanks for tuning in. Today we are checking out the Kaiser Tauser K, which is a very, very interesting and a knife that I love very much. But first, let's talk about a couple little housekeeping things. We are almost reached 100 subscribers, and as I've mentioned in previous videos, we're going to be doing a giveaway once I reach that milestone. We're not going to be doing a giveaway every 100 subscribers here on forward, but I feel like my first 100 is a momentous occasion. I'm very excited about it. So we're going to be doing a giveaway. I'm at 99 right now, so stay tuned. There's going to be a video coming out soon giving you the details on how to enter a giveaway. So we're going to be giving away at least one knife, possibly a couple other things. And there's only 100 of you, so your chances of winning are, you know, pretty good, 1 in 100. So stay tuned for that. And the second thing is, look at this. I burnt the crap out of my hand at work 2 days ago, and that is just one long blister. It hurts so freaking bad. So bad. Luckily, it happened towards the end of the day at work, so I only had to kill about an hour before I went home. I got some burn spray, and that didn't do shit. What else did I do? I tried everything. Pretty much the only thing that ended up working was just submerging my hand in an icy bucket of water. And luckily, around midnight that night, it stopped hurting. So, but for, I mean, you guys have probably had burns before. The pain is just, it just really sucks. And as soon as you take it out of the ice, it's just bam. It hurts. It sucks. And I can't imagine having, a large burn over your whole arm or your whole body. I can't even fathom the pain that must be. So, it's not a super bad burn, but it for sure hurt. And it's definitely a big, long blister. So, yep, just wanted to show you guys that. And, yeah, ouch. Okay, let's talk about the Kaiser Tauser K. These things come in at around $70 new. I picked this one up used recently, but it is in very good condition. You may think this is a G10 scale, but it's actually a material called Richlite. And I don't know a whole lot about it, but I know that it's more like micarta than G10. You can kind of see on the end grain there, you can see some grains in there. I'm not sure if it's like a fabric or, like a resin-covered fabric kind of deal. I'm not sure. But I really love the milling pattern on there. Really like that. And this also comes in a red micarta version as well, if you prefer that. So we're looking at a cleaver style sheep's foot blade. We have an overall length of 7.9 inches. Let's get my ruler out. So overall we are at, 7.9, about 8. We have a blade length of 3.39 inches, about 3 3/8. And we have a blade stock thickness of 0.13 inches, a weight of 4.27 ounces. Alrighty, I'm going to have to let my dog out. I thought he'd be quiet for me this time, but nope, he can't do it. So, 1 second, please. Sorry about that, folks. I appreciate you bearing with me. So, we have a blade material of 154 cm, which I like very much. It's one of my favorite kind of, I wouldn't call it a lower end steel, but I'd call it a mid-grade steel. Takes a very, very clean, keen edge. Guys, the action on this knife is unbelievable. I mean, look at this. Absolutely falls shut to the max. This is the smoothest knife I own, without a doubt. And the reason it's so smooth is because Kaiser is using a some kind of a multi-row bearing system in there. You can kind of see there how the bearing cages are kind of nested into the blade there, or the tang. I haven't taken apart to really check it out, but all I know is it's just extremely smooth. Detent is fantastic. You can hear that click. Yep, fantastic detent. I can reverse flick this baby very easily. And man, this thing is just, it's so fun to mess around with. It is so freaking smooth, unbelievable. We have a deep carry pocket clip. You know, nothing fancy. Just, you know, your typical stamped wire, pocket clip. The guy that I bought this from had been missing the hardware for the pocket clip, so I had to find some screws for it. So the only ones I had were the kind of the rounded head ones, but this knife does come from Kaiser with flat head screws in there, so when you get yours, they're not going to be poking up like that at all, so that's nice. Let's talk about ergonomics. This knife is very, very comfortable to hold on to. It's kind of an interesting handle shape. We have a very large kind of finger groove here, and then it slopes out and kind of there's kind of a fat section here in the middle, which is just really comfortable. And then we have a little choke up position. We have some jimping here, so you can choke up and get really nice and close to that blade. And if you've been watching my videos and you know me at all, you know that this is my jam. I love to choke up on knives. It feels weird to me to be too far back from the blade, so this suits me very well. I really like it. Great jimping on the spine. This is the type of jimping I love. Nice and fine, grippy, and it's the same jimping here as on the spine. What else? Let me wipe it off here. Really love this blade shape. Just really good for everything, really. We have a nice sharpening choil there. You're going to be able to get a lot of sharpens out of this thing. You know, this knife I feel like is geared for kind of like not necessarily just food prep, but you know, tasks that are similar to that. And the reason being is if you look at my knuckles in relation to the blade, the blade is really far this way, meaning that if I was cutting something flat on the ground, I can get to almost that full edge without my fingers hitting the surface. Let's look at another knife, for example. If I put my knuckles down on the table, that blade is so far away. You know, I can't get to the heel of the blade. I can only get to the tip here before my knuckles hit. But with this knife, look at all that room I have. Look at how much blade can touch the surface before it bottoms out on my knuckles. So that's really nice. Just great for chopping, for slicing, you know, pretty much everything. I mean, I love that the tip is low. You know, you're not raising your hand up too far this way to get to that tip for your utility cuts or any kind of similar cutting tasks. This knife is just, it's built really well. It's designed very well. And I feel like it's just a cutting machine. Let's do some size comparisons. Let's first check out the Spyderco's since I got my PM2 out. Pretty similar in size to the PM2, a little bit smaller. The Mannix 2 is about the same, a little bit larger than the Kaiser. By the way, I'm going to mention this in every video, but I'm loving my CME, my Compression Lock Made Easy. It took a little bit of getting used to, just to get it down. You know, the placement of my finger, but I'm dialed in, guys, and I'm loving it. Left-handed, very easy to operate. If you own a Spyderco with a compression lock, I really recommend getting one. It's a CME called Compression Lock Made Easy, and they're sold by OCD4EDC. Highly recommend them. All right, how about some Pylars? Pylar Large, Pylar 3. There you go. And lastly, some Benchmades. We got the Benchmade Bug Out and Benchmade Mini Adamas. There you go. Full-size knife. Guys, I feel like this is kind of a sleeper. I don't see a whole lot of people talking about this knife. You know, people usually choose maybe the Sheepdog over this. Maybe they just don't know about it, or, you know, for whatever reason. This knife is amazing. It's just incredible. The action, ergonomics, design, everything. I really love this knife. Highly recommend it. For $70, incredible, incredible. You're getting amazing action, great steel, great design. $70, you can't beat it. And that's going to do it. Thanks for watching, y'all. Adios.